this campaign started from the day we taken over the charge of society, because that was in December 16, when our society formed by the end of December. Then we got a huge bill. We were getting maintenance bill that was around 18,000 to 15,000 range per month. So then we analyzed, and from there we could know that this electricity charge that was coming around 3,60,000 to 4 lakhs rupees per month. So that was a huge cost. So we thought immediately we should cut that cost, so that at least that will have a direct impact on the maintenance bill. So from the maintenance bill itself, we got, everybody got encouraged that we should do something. So that 3,60,000, 3,70,000 per month, which was coming in December, now it is hardly 90,000 rupees. So that's a reduction of about 70-75%. And we are not still saturated with this. We are planning for one more project, that is 16.5 kilowatt.
There is a misconception that in rainy season the solar generates power. Even in rainy season there is a daylight, okay, and solar only requires, the solar photovoltaic cells require diffuse daylight to generate power. It requires a startup voltage. If it gets that startup voltage, it starts to generate power, okay. So only the difference is in summers, winters and in rainy seasons you will get 20 to 25% less generation. But less generation, as in you calculate over the year, you will generate around 1500 units per kilowatt per year.
From Maharashtra government rule, the company, power companies are taking initiative to do this. So what we do is we supply the power generated from the solar to their grid. In return, we get it from them, and the difference is calculated into the bill.
Residents of Rehija Eternity have shown that if there is a will, there is a way. Apart from going all solar, the complex also boasts of rainwater harvesting system, and it also has a fully automatic compost converter. Surely, this example of sustainable living should be replicated across all our cities. In Mumbai, Ashwini Priyolkar.